Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at the Touch Bar on the new MacBook Pro. So of course the Touch Bar is a separate screen from my main screen, but thanks to this free little app Touche here, I can see what's on the Touch Bar and put it on my main screen here, so when I screen capture for you, you could see what I'm seeing. So you could see here the basic Touch Bar has the Escape key on the left and everything on the right depends upon what app you're using. Here I'm using the Finder. I have a Finder window selected. I have a folder selected. So I can see a lot of different things here in the Touch Bar that relate to the Finder, like Quick Look, Sharing, Tagging, and things expand. So for instance, I'm going to hit the button here that you can see is the equivalent to this button here in the Finder that will let me see different viewing styles for the Finder. And you can see it expands there and I've got an X button on the left that can get me out of it. Also, if I ever want to return to see the function keys, I just hold the FN key on my keyboard down and it all changes to the function keys. So I can get to that. Now, how about all those things like volume and brightness and everything like that? Well, those appear over here, but there's not enough room for all of them because I'm using an app right now. So I've got this little button here. I can use that and expand, and there are all of those controls. Now you can customize this. If you go to System Preferences, and under Keyboard and the first tab here, Keyboard, you've got some things here where you can say the Touch Bar shows and here it's App Controls with Control Strip, but you can have it always show the expanded Control Strip or always just show the full App Controls with no Control Strip. And you can also show what happens when the FN key is pressed. So here it changes to the F keys, or I can have it automatically expand the Control Strip. If you never use the F keys, that's a good option for you. So what about other apps? Well, let's go and look at a whole bunch of them. Let's start with TextEdit here. And you can see in TextEdit, I've got these suggestions here at the top. As I type, you can see it gives me suggestions and I can actually tap it, very similar to an iOS. Or I could tap and get rid of that and it shows me font controls. And I can also get that if I select something. So for instance, if I wanted to change the color, I would tap there and I can pick a new color for it. So there's a lot you can do here by expanding these menus by touching the buttons. Now let's go to, say, iTunes. And in iTunes, we have playback controls, as you would imagine, skip controls, up next controls. We have forward and backward buttons there. If we go to things like Keynote, we've got all sorts of controls here specific for Keynote. And what's very useful is going to be if you play a Keynote presentation, you can see small thumbnails of the slides. You can jump to them. You can see your time there. So you have some very useful controls. And this is the first time I can show you that you can slide back and forth here like that. So you just put your finger down and slide back and forth for viewing a longer list. If we go to Numbers, we can see we've got number specific buttons there. And as I start typing a formula, it even changes. And it will continue to change as I do different things in Numbers. I can go to Pages, and I've got a similar set of controls that we saw in TextEdit. We can bring up suggestions. We can change colors. Do all sorts of things and change styles. If I go to Photos, we can scrub through different photos in the current collection. We can use the Touch Bar to access adjustments. And you can see in some of them, like say if I wanted to go to like a light adjustment here, I can actually scrub along here on the Touch Bar to adjust and even turn on things on and off. If I go to Notes, I've got text editing things here on Notes, similar to what's in the toolbar there. Calendar, I can do different things here in the calendar depending upon what I've got selected. So if I haven't selected anything here, I can actually jump to a different month. If I select something, I can do different things with it, like add invites and adjust the time, things like that. If I go to Contacts, I can select a contact and I can instantly start a phone call or FaceTime or send an email or send a message from there. And if Finally, the last one I'm going to show you is in Safari. You can see here you've got this, some parts of the Safari toolbar at the bottom here. Like you can start a new tab or window. You can tap to start searching for something. If I go into a web page, and let's say I do another one as well, you can see I see thumbnails there that I can jump back and forth between the different tabs in Safari. So there's a lot of different things that will happen. Also, notice that if I try to do anything with the dialog box, I'm just going to hit Command S here to do a save. And you can see I have cancel and save buttons there in the dialog, and they appear in the touch bar as well. So it's kind of like a keyboard shortcut for those. And it says cancel and save because that's what's in that dialog. Other dialogs will show other types of buttons like OK and cancel and such. It's going to be very useful. So that's a quick look at what the touch bar is capable of. Third-party apps are starting to adopt it as well, and we're going to see probably lots of adjustments. You can also customize the touch bar. To do that, go to System Preferences, and then back into where we were before, Keyboard, and there's Customized Control Strip. I don't know why it's called that there, but here you can see you can drag and drop items into the touch bar. So you just take them and drag them below. So if I wanted to add, say, Mission Control here, I can go ahead and do that. I can add Launchpad, Notification Center, a lot of different things that you can do to customize some of the things in the control strip. So let's add Mission Control instead of Brightness. I'll do that by dragging down to the bottom and dropping it in there. And then hit Done. And now my control strip, my touch bar, shows this Mission Control button here instead of the brightness control.